Tony, calling from Sioux Falls, South Dakota, listening on EWTN on The Lamb 91.3. Hello, Tony.
Hey, Tim. I got a pretty easy question here, I think, for you.
Okay.
We were at a church over the weekend that did not have a tabernacle in the sanctuary. So we were wondering, do you genuflect when you enter next to the pew?
No, if there is no tabernacle. Now, we should clarify here, Tony, just because there's no tabernacle doesn't mean the Lord's not present. Of course, he could be exposed in the Blessed Sacrament in a monstrance or something, but if the Lord is not present in a tabernacle or in some other way, then you do not genuflect. If you're coming into the sanctuary, you would then bow toward the altar. You don't bow to, or you don't genuflect to the altar because the altar is not Christ, but we bow to it in honor of that sacred place where Jesus is about to become present for us. Does that make sense, Tony?
Makes sense, yeah, because and then we weren't real sure when we got in because we didn't see the Eucharistic candle or anything.
Right.
And then after communion, I watched and the EME took it out through the back entrance into the side chapel.
Gotcha. Yep. It's unfortunate, Tony. I tell you, it's. I travel a lot and speak all over the world, and often I'll come into a new church, and it's, you know, where's Jesus? It takes you a while to find where our Lord is, which is really contrary to what we believe ought to be as Catholics. I mean, our Lord is supposed to be in a distinct place, in a place of honor, where, you know, he's easy to find. Of course, I believe he should be right in the center. And the church does seem to be moving in that direction toward having our Lord in the center. But even if he's off to the side, as we have in the Vatican, for example, you know, he's in a distinctive place and not in a closet somewhere behind. You know, there are times where you do a 360 and you can't find Jesus. Then find, oh, there he is. He's way back behind us in what looks like a closet. I think that's unfortunate. But anyway, Tony, thanks for your call. And by the way, there's no such thing as a question that is either stupid or one that shouldn't be asked when it comes to our Catholic faith, because, Tony, there are other people out there that needed to hear the answer to the question you just asked. I always say there's no such thing as a stupid question, only stupid answers. And we will try not to give you stupid answers here at Catholic.